many years ago before I was born, just up in Southport. My granddad was a butcher. To see all the old pictures of the meat hanging outside the shop and tales of my dad going on doing the deliveries for him all around Umskirk on his bike, it opened my eyes up. I was able to connect the animal to my food. I was always interested in the meat and what my granddad did. I always looked up to my granddad. He was fantastic. The relationship that I have with my butcher now is fantastic. It's all about communication. He's based on just outside Liverpool city centre. If I need anything, or if something's run short, or if the quality's not right in my eyes, he'll come out personally and deliver me something that is of the quality that we need. Chefs don't want to be left waiting. They want everything now, or they want everything yesterday. But with Martin, the relationship I've got is fantastic, and the quality of the gear that he usually sends in is A1. It's really, really good. I think when I was in Australia, it felt as if there wasn't as much flavour. I know obviously New Zealand lamb is very sought after and supposed to be, you know, really, really good quality, but I prefer the British meat. Feels as if it's more mature, there's more flavour to it. I don't see why we have to go elsewhere when we've got fantastic produce in the Northwest. I think it's better than the New Zealand gear that you can get. So Panoramic's been open for 11 years now. They've always done, you know, high-end fine dining. We do some classic dishes, but we also do some modern takes on dishes. I use a lot of Lancashire beef, lamb. Because we're in a city, I think sometimes people don't really look at from where it's from. I think they just see the price tag and they think, oh, hang on a minute, that's a bit much for this, that and the other. But for me, I think for the sustainability, we try and keep all our produce around Lancashire and the Northwest. With the prices of the food, we see it as a destination restaurant. We got a lot of guests who come in for special occasions, birthdays, graduations, anniversaries. I think it's really important that we use a good quality lamb. The guests that are coming in to the restaurant are paying, you know, top prices for the lamb and the experience. So we need to make sure it's at the best quality. We need to make sure it's matured enough, that it's not too young. And we also need to make sure that the seasoning on the lamb and the way it's prepared is treated correctly and lovingly. So we're going to do a lamb saddle with a loin skewer, which is going to be glazed in Marmite. It's going to have a bit of mint on top. I'm going to serve that with a beetroot ketchup. And we're also going to do a little rib of the lamb as well, which is going to be on the side. I'm using hogget. Hogget's obviously a matured lamb, so it's easier to get hold of around the year. I think with spring lamb, there's a certain window that you have to try and get your lamb in. So if I was using spring lamb, I would use it for maybe 2 months, but with a hogget I can use it for a longer period of time. But what I'll do is I'll bone the saddle. I will then take the outer loins, which are the top bones, and I will slice them, and then I'll brine them, put them on a skewer. I'll then season them and just leave them for a little bit. I'll dice the shoulder, I'll make a farce out of it. I will add onion seed, shallots, and a mixture of herbs, tarragon, chervil, mint. I will then stuff that back into the saddle that's been boned, and then I'll roll it, and then I'll sous vide it on 52 degrees overnight for 12 hours. I'll then take it out, sear it on the outside, caramelise all the fat on the outside, and then portion it up. So with the dish, I'll put a beetroot ketchup. Beetroot's coming from Lancashire, just outside of Southport, and I'll use some heritage carrots on the dish as well. I'll also use a carrot which has been cooked in a lamb glaze and then portioned and then charred using the blowtorch. I think the saddle is the main component of the dish. That's what we try and get as much taste into as possible. So the farce going into it has to be tasty, it has to be fresh. You've got the loins on either side, which is the bulk of the meat. I think obviously getting the caramelization on the lamb is a big must. and to render down the fat. You don't want a piece of lamb that's got, you know, a large quantity of fat on. It can be off-putting to some people. Using the QSM standard of meat is fantastic. We know that it's the British produce, and as I said earlier on, you can't get much better. Yeah, you can't go wrong with it. I think it's good to have those relationships because you can build on them and you can take them throughout your career. If you start off just knowing the person on a one-to-one basis and then going visiting them and using them and contacting them day in, day out, and you build up that rapport with them, I think it's great for a young chef.